Okay, so welcome everyone. Those that are here and those that are waiting or watching in the wings. This is part of NodeX30, the 30-day challenge campaign for you to reach out to one person a day across Google Plus based upon what your interests are or what you find interests you about that a specific person. So we're going to keep it fairly simple here. Okay, so that's just something going off in the background. And purely take you through an example of how you can use Nodex to identify these people based on the projects that you may have already started. If you want to join in and you're just watching in the background at the moment, click on the Join Hangout and you'll appear here as well. And feel free to stop me and ask any questions that you may have. So right now I'm just going to share my screen with you and show you a project dashboard, which is just a basic one. It's on movies and television, which is one of my things that I like to look at. So I'll just share my screen here. And if you can just let me know when you can see my screen or the graph.
I can see it, Steve.
Yep, it's
Finally.
pinned now.
Fantastic. Okay. So first things first, from a my own personal perspective. Hi, Wade. Hi, Wade. from my own personal perspective, what I do when I'm doing outreach, whether it's on behalf of myself or on behalf of my clients, is I tend to look at the dots which aren't getting any form of engagement. And by that I mean these single dots here. So you can just hover over them, you can see there's no engagement at all, unlike these ones here where they're surrounded by other dots, other different colored dots. So before we carry on, let's just explain what those colored dots mean. Start with the blue dots themselves are originating posts. Those are people that are posting a specific piece of content that's related to a search phrase that you've added to your project. In this particular instance, my project was movies being one keyword and then another one being television. Now, that's the blue dots. The orange dots actually represent plus ones, people that are plus oneing a piece of content. The purple dots are those people that are commenting on that originating post. And the green dots are those people that are resharing that content. Okay? So, as an example, let's select this person here, Kareem Jackman. And what I'm going to do is, first of all, I'm just hovering over her, and you can see there's some centrality statistics there, which I'll go into a little bit more detail shortly about. But if we want to see her exact post, I'm just going to click on it, and there I can actually see what the content that she posted that created that bunch of engagement there, where we can see, you know, several plus ones and reshares, etc., etc. All right. Now, if I wanted to, I could actually add her. She's already in my circles anyway, but I could actually add her to different circles directly from here. I can comment on her post, or I can plus one her post directly from here. And what that actually means is I can then use Nodex as a focused engagement application, as well as an influencer stroke community identification application as well, which can help focus my time. But I'll leave that to possibly some questions that you may have later. From a specific part of our Node X30 challenge then is I want to see, you know, some new people that are posting great content, not necessarily receiving the awareness or engagement that they should be receiving. And from here, what I'm going to do is just select any one of these nodes. I tend to don't select ones which have blue heads, like this one. So this person's got I Love Freebies. Okay, there's a blue head, another blue head, another blue head. And you can probably see why some of these aren't actually getting any engagement because of the blue heads. But that's a topic of conversation for another time. What I'm going to do right now is just click on this one. And again, I'm not sure what the content is, whatever. So if anything comes up in here, you're seeing it as is. So please excuse anything which may come through. And this one's shot up here because it includes the word movie twice in here and also within the slide description. Now, if I felt, you know, after clicking through to this link, that this person was somebody that I could reach out to and I like, then I could add them to, say, my entertainment circle, or more importantly, my Node X30 circle, yeah, which is all part of this campaign. And then I could plus one the content and actually start commenting on their content. Because as we know, you know, in order to receive engagement ourselves on our content, we are more likely to if we engage on other people's content first. So we're trying to, in a subconscious way, tell them or mentor them an approach for receiving more engagement on their content. So, you know, showing a best practice, if you like. So that'd be one way from here. Let's find another post. Again, I don't click on blue heads. I'm going to look at Ryan Martinez. And his post here, so, you know, we spent a little bit of time here. Quick question to you. What's probably the reason he isn't getting any engagement at this point in time? What do you think?
No image.
No image, absolutely. Yeah. You know, and it's something which various people on Google Plus are talking about. You know, we as people and humans, we're more motivated and eyes are drawn to images than to text initially. So again, this is just another one of those instances where we can basically advise, not necessarily straight away on this post, but as we start to build a relationship with an individual, who can say, look, I'm just going to read this post. Anybody notice the trend that movie TV trailers are using is also used by drug ads? Okay, so this is quite a contentious post. They put the logo on the top of the movie frame, the letterbox, blah, 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 blah. So he's obviously thought about it, you know. And just in this particular instance, what I'm going to do is I'm going to add him to my circles, and I'm going to come back to it later and then re-comment on that post. I won't necessarily state something better that could highlight his post, but maybe he could have put an example of the image of what he's talking about, you know, this letterbox on top of the trailer, which would really have highlighted what his train of thought. So in terms of the Node X30 challenge, that's basically all I do. And from there, it's, you know, I'm very quick to kind of just highlight over people randomly until, okay, here's we've got film 6. They're not getting any form of engagement at the moment. They just posted an image, but nothing else and no content. So I'm not very likely to... I don't really know what they're trying to say here, and probably you don't either. More blue heads. You know, one of the things, if you're looking as a separate project, if you like, is to bring new people or help educate new people, the likes of... Dennis or Martin Shervington, etc., things like this, Dennis LaBelle, I mean, then one could be that, you know, you start looking or engaging with blue heads more and, you know, say, look, you know, you're going to get more engagement on your posts if you revert from a blue head to a profile pic. People can start seeing you. So that could be a separate thing altogether. Similarly, I'm just going to try and find a few bits more. Anything else? Okay, here we've got rock and roll pages. Let's have a look. Okay, so, you know, this person's got a link in here. They've got a bit of content on there, et cetera, et cetera. And I tend not to pick and choose who I follow based on country, et cetera. It's purely whether it ticks a box in my mind at this specific time. And I don't know how if that's the same for you as well. Does that answer or show you how I'm going about my Node X 30 in my own way?
Yeah. I love it.
Yeah. Is anybody experiencing any issues when you're doing this at the moment, or have you got any feedback from those people that you've already started following, or have they followed you back, or, you know, how are you finding it at this moment in time?
I've picked up several followers, Lee, and I've actually started working with a guy out in California already.
You're kidding?
Through reaching out, no.
Wow, fantastic.
Now, I wasn't using it like you just showed me. I put in my interest, and then I clicked on, after it ran the report, I clicked on the negative posts and the positive posts and found people that way.
Yeah.
But what you just showed me is more effective or efficient, I should say, and I like that a lot better. So I look forward to using it that way.
Okay. I mean, I spend all my day pretty much looking at dots and graphs like this because I can focus. I'm just going to mute Wade for a moment because I think he's got just some children in the background. But basically, from this graph, though, I can tell who is getting engagement, who's not getting engagement. So I can really focus my attention on, depending on my different objectives for the day.
Sure.
Or task, you know. And for example, what I can also do here is apply different algorithms in the graph order. And if I can just show you that, and it can tell us a lot of interesting things. So I'm just going to share my screen again with you. And in here, on the right-hand side, under the Manage Graph area, once you've got, you know, a fair bit of data in here, you can actually increase the number of entries being displayed within your graph as well. So, and I'll show you what I mean by that in a moment, but under the graph order, at the moment when you're looking at it is what's called simple. It's a simple, what's called a non-directed graph. You can't really identify the way the relationships are, as in, if we were to not show the color changes, you wouldn't really know what each of those nodes were. However, if I look at, or if I'm trying to find people that are the most engaged on posts, then what I would do is select out degree. And out degree prioritizes those people that are engaging more on other people's content. All right. Now, I'm just going to highlight that fact here just by changing the layout settings, because sometimes it's not as clear because if we have more and more nodes. And I'm going to minimize the smaller nodes and then just click Apply. And then, obviously, now the graph changes completely. Yeah. And from here, what I can do is say, okay, I actually just want to remove some of the posts that aren't getting anything at all. And that now leaves me with just these nodes, these dots, which show me the most engaged users on other people's posts. Yeah? So, from this then, things become very, very different depending on our focus. You know, if we're looking to try and find more engaged users, then we would do it this way. You know? That's one way of doing it. If I'm looking to try and find who the most influential people are amongst other influencers within a graph, I would select eigenvector centrality. Now you can see that graph's completely changed. Yeah? I'm just going to highlight that fact a little bit more. Now, eigenvector centrality in terms of online social network analysis, what it actually does is identify influencers amongst other influencers. So as an example, if you or your page that you manage on Google Plus, you are wanting to be positioned as an influencer, then one of the things you're going to want to track is your eigenvector centrality, i.e. how positioned are you amongst other influencers within a certain discussion topic. And remember, this is done on a per topic basis as opposed to individuals. Because the top layer, because in order to start a project, we use keywords as descriptors to find conversations that are relating to those keywords that we've used. That's the top level. And then beneath that, we find who are the people talking about those discussions. So each graph is very different. And although you may talk about several different topics, your influencer score or rating will change from topic to topic, right? So what's interesting, if let's say you wanted to be an influencer amongst movies and television, one of the key things here then that you're going to want to record over history is where are you positioned amongst these influences using the eigenvector or the nodes by. Does that make sense? Yeah?
Yep.
Then one of the things you can then do is rather than click on the relations link to get to these graphs again, which, just to let you know, can take a little bit of time, because what we're actually doing when we're building these graphs together, I'm just going to come off screen share for the time being. One of the things we're doing is, because we index all of the posts, when we build a graph, a relationship graph like this, what we're actually doing is then we're then going to go and fetch all of the engagements relating to each post, bring them back, and then display the results. Now you can imagine if, for example, a popular topic like movies and television or photography or something like that, then that can take some time to pull in all the latest engagements. So one of the things that you can do to save that time is to save this graph to a new feature that we've added, and that's called Save the Graph to Our Gallery. So from here, all I would do is click Save on here, and then you'll get let me go back and share my screen with you. Let me know when you can see that.
Yeah, it appears now.
Okay. Absolutely. Perfect. So in here, all I'm going to enter is just a graph name, movies and television. All right. And in here, what I'm going to do is enter the total nodes and connections I've got in here. So, and I get that under graph statistics on the right-hand side. So what you can see there is I've got total nodes. So all I'm going to do is just total nodes equals 391 and connections equals 112. And that just helps me identify which graph I'm going to be looking at or loading from the gallery. Then I'm just going to click Save on Graph, and then it will tell me it's done. And then that's it. Now, to access that graph, if you then hover over the My Graphs, you'll see the drop-down says right at the bottom, Graph Gallery. Now, if I click on Graph Gallery, I then get my my latest graph that I've added, which is here, Movies and Television, Total Nodes, 391. And connections equals 112. Yeah? Now, in order to load that, all I do is just click it, and it will open up, and you can see how fast that loaded then. Can you see that?
Yes.
So that saves a lot of time for you, and you can also use them as comparative graphs as well, so you can split test them, you know? Let's say, you know, in the previous one here, I'm going to go back to my gallery. I've got movies and television most engaged, and in this one I've got 5,225 nodes. Wow. Okay. So I'm going to load that one up now just to show you how quick that one can load up in the time frame. And there's 5,000 nodes just loaded up.
Wow.
Okay. So you can see, rather than just having to hang around and wait for a graph to reload each time from the relations section, mm-hmm. using it this way, you can retrieve anything that you were looking at previously and then go back to it at any specific time. But then again, you can also use it in exactly the same way. For example, I can, you know, manipulate the graph, selecting eigenvector again, and then only display, you know, the most influential posts within that graph. So I can manipulate it in exactly the same way as if I was doing it from the real-time graph. Hmm. Yeah. So does that help from a basic, you know, overview of trying to use Nodex from this Nodex 30 challenge?
Yeah, in that saved graph version, you can click on the dots and do exactly the same thing.
Yeah, absolutely. Let me show you that. So we've included everything that was in there previously. So, for example, I can hover over a node and I can get all the centrality statistics. Okay. I can click on the node and I can also then get the embedded post. And therefore, you can do exactly the same. You know, you can follow this individual or add to your circles. You can plus one on the content or comment on the content as well. So everything's exactly the same as if it would or was in real time.
Right, I see that.
Okay. Sorry, go on.
I have a question because I learned a new word today and I want to make sure I understand it. Eigenvector.
Yeah. So there are different types of what's called centrality. And before I explain what centrality is, if we review, I won't mention them by name, but you know you can get these influencer sites that give you a score and say how influential you are, and they kind of list these topics.
Right.
You know, what they do is great, you know. But and for the most part, most people are happy with those scores, and that's fine. Yeah. What we're trying to do is to say, though, you know, not everyone is influential across all of their topics that they discuss or post about in exactly the same way. So if I got a certain score of, let's say, 500, and I talk about six different topics daily, I can't be, that score doesn't reflect how influential I am across all of those different topics.
I get you.
So these different centrality statistics or measures are actually, it's not something I've created or invented myself. They come from what's called formal offline social network analysis. They've been around for decades.
Oh, okay.
They're tried and proven methods of identifying influences or communities within graphs, okay? And each one do different things. And on snafix.com, I've listed what those things are, but I'll take you through them right now. And once you start to get your head around them and what each one does, and then how it manipulates the graph and therefore tells you the information. I'm not sharing my screen now, right? No.
No.
What each one is trying to tell you, you can basically then define a strategic path on and a focus on what you're trying to achieve right now. So, as an example, the forms of centrality that we use here are degree, in degree, out degree, which actually form together degree centrality. Then we've got eigenvector, closeness centrality, betweenness centrality. And that there are others, and we are implementing more. But let's describe what those ones are. So if I describe what in-degree centrality means, from this perspective, if I posted something, and let's say, you know, you, Steve, and Wade, then one of you plus one my content, another one commented on that content, and let's say, Les, you reshared it. Yeah. Mm-hmm. From an in degree perspective, I would have three in degree, or in degree three. Right. Whereas I'd have a plus one link coming back in, I'd have a reshare link coming back into my post, and also a comment coming back into my post.
Okay.
Out degree is the opposite. Yeah. So what we'd be seeing there is how engaging I am on other people. Yeah. Other people's. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So if I've got a high degree centrality, or if people have a high degree centrality, what you'll then see, or you can gather, is that this person likes to engage on other people's posts.
Mm. Okay.
All right. Mm-hmm. Those two combined, in degree and out degree, give you a total degree or degree centrality score. It's the total of in degree and out degree. Yeah.
Okay.
Eigenvector, and I'm talking about this specifically in terms of social network analysis online, okay. Is identification of influencers talking about a specific subject matter and how. Where are you or other influencers positioned within those influencers, if you like? Okay. Just as an aside, Google's original algorithm, PageRank algorithm, is a derivative of Eigenvector. All right. It started out as Eigenvector, and then Larry Page converted it more for links coming into different websites. And this is where we got our ranking within search results.
Okay.
So Eigenvector, in terms of where we are, is identifying people within discussions that are influential. And does a profile influence other influencers, if you see what I mean? So that's a really important one to get your head around.
Yeah.
Closeness centrality identifies, if a person identified within a graph, they reshared it, how... from them, how does the information travel from them across the network? So someone with a high closeness centrality means that if they reshared it, chances are it's going to fly out from them. Okay? So what you want is a group of these people with high closeness within your network who are highly engaged on your content.
Yes.
From a betweenness centrality perspective, this actually identifies... weak points within your network. Now let's just say, you know, I'm posting content here, and this kind of ties in quite well with the Nodex 30 challenge, because, you know, we've been around a little bit on Google+, and we're actively going out to try and find new people that aren't getting awareness on their content that they should be, you know. So let's say we start resharing their content now. The chances are other people are going to pick up the content that we've reshared from them, right? And what that then means, if we then took you out of the equation, then that person's content would fail to be seen, at least for a period of time again. Right. You with me? So these are the weak spots within a network. And between the centrality can actually identify those weaknesses. Yeah. Uh-huh. So, for example, if I saw that, you know, you and Steve were just sharing my content all the time, and without you, I wouldn't have, my content wouldn't be seen,
mm-hmm.
then I'd need to do several things in order to support expand my network to make sure that, you know, if you and Steve left for whatever reason or, you know, stop sharing, you were away on holiday, whatever, and I've got some key posts going out, then I'd be stuffed, you know?
Right, right.
My information that I'm trying to get out, my message that I'm trying to get out is not traveling at all. So the between the centrality really identifies that.
Ah, okay.
Yeah. So we are going to be adding more on these. Some of them are derivatives of those ones, but as a starting point, we try to include the main ones that are actually used within SNA the most to help us focus what we need to do. Yeah.
Very cool.
Is that all right?
Very cool, yeah.
Great stuff.
Absolutely.
Now, I know I've gone 10 minutes over on this Hangout, so I apologize for that. But, you know, whoever's watching or taking part now, again, if you do have any questions at all, feel free to post comments on the...
Let me ask Lee, because I've noticed some of my posts, especially when those influencers or those, I can't remember the term you used to describe those people who share my stuff, and it just flies from there.
Yeah, closeness.
Closers?
Yeah, closeness, yeah.
Closeness, yeah. I've noticed there are times when I'll share content and it doesn't travel, it doesn't. So what could I do specifically in those instances to increase the likelihood that it would travel without them?
Without them, yeah. I mean, that's a great question, and it all forms part of how are your relationships within your network, your followers. Yeah. Okay. One of the key things you can actually do is to use I tend to use this. I like to study my own graph on Google Plus. So if you and I'm just going to just share my screen with you here. In here, then, what you're going to want to do is look at. There's two things. First of all, one is Google Plus activities. Okay, and in here we've got load my activities or load others activities, and I'll leave load others because I've got a blog post coming on that tomorrow. But on load my activities, it's going to let that just load up, and what it does, it analyzes each of your posts, okay, from an engagement perspective. And it pulls in all of the data, those people that reshared, those people that commented, and those people that plus one your content. Excuse me. And from there, what we're able to do is say, okay, if we were looking at, I'll just let that load up in the background, and then when it comes live.
All right.
Share from here. So, is that clicked off? Is it still loading?
Still loading on this end.
That's weird. Okay, there we go. So, what this identifies is it builds a graph of each of your posts, okay? And from there, it looks and identifies each of the different forms of engagement each of your posts got. From this is kind of a useful tool to identify people that were engaging more on one post than on another. For me, the questions that I ask are, okay, I've got these series of people that reshared the content, and then I can ask certain questions. Well, they reshared this one, but why didn't they reshare that one? So then I could send them a private message and say, I noticed you reshared this one, and you know, like as you know, I was grateful for that and I commented on it, etc. Is there a reason? What would have made you share this one? Is there something I didn't quite tick a box in your mind? You know, right. Could I have made it better? Eight times out of ten, it comes back to I missed it. I missed the post.
Oh.
Yeah. So it's a notification issue. Yeah. In which case, you know, we can then ask them, great. So if you would like to see more of these posts,
okay.
Like okay. Shall I add you to a notification circle where you also get an email? And then you start to build a different relationship with these people that will grow. And therefore, you start to get people that get notified of when a post goes out. You've notified them, and the chances are they're going to share it. So as an example, this is the graph of my Google Plus activity. Let me know when you can see that. Can you see the graph?
Yeah, I can see it now.
Okay. So this is a shot of my recent activity. Okay. Now, as it looks like that, you know, we can get a basic understanding of what's going on there. Blue nodes in this specific instance are my posts. Okay. And then the same things apply. Greens are reshares of my posts. Orange are plus ones of my posts. And the purples are comments on my posts. Yeah. Now, by applying certain graph order, i.e. in degree, out degree, I can manipulate the graph to tell me more information that I need to be more effective. So, for example, if I change this here now to out degree, okay, and I'm just going to filter down, I've just increased the filter there. Can you see what I've done just on the right-hand side? Filter graph. Yeah. I can now see who the most people that are engaging on my posts. Yeah, so I've got John, I've got Yoko, I've got Cody, and I've got Troy, you know, and it actually shows which posts they're commenting on here just by highlighting over. Yeah, so from this perspective, I can see the type of behavior each person has on my posts. You with me?
Yes.
And that helps a lot. In terms of saying, right, what do I need to do now? You know, I always look at, if someone's resharing my post, I'm very, very grateful, you know.
Yes.
But they may not be commenting on it, or they may not be adding their own insight as they share it, you know. Because I want to encourage their get more engagement on that post as well. Yeah. So it could be that I start in the thing, I say, okay, you reshared this, thanks ever so much, but... You know, why did you reshare it? What was the one thing? And I'll do that in a comment on their reshare.
Okay.
Try and spark a conversation on their post. Not on mine. Yeah? On their reshare.
Oh, okay.
Yeah? So that's what I do from there. Because, you know, I'm very grateful for anyone that reshares a piece of content. And if someone has, then let's start that conversation with them and their people, because it could ensue into something else. And I actually spend more time engaging on other people's content than I do on mine. Yeah?
Yes.
Now, from there then, I can go back to my graph here and say, okay, well, now let's have a look at all the posts of just my posts which are getting the most engagement. So I select in degree, and if we remember what in degree was, the amount of links coming back in, and those links are plus ones, or reshares. Then I'm just going to manipulate the graph slightly, increasing the maximum number of nodes, say to 15, and we can see the blue nodes therefore get bigger. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And I'm going to reduce the minimum size down to 0. Okay, and that really highlights to me and just shows exactly which posts are getting the most. Yeah.
Right.
So I can go up here, and you can see this is where the centrality statistics, obviously it's going to be on myself, but I can see which post is this one. Okay, and this one got 1,690. And if we can just check again on here, view the post activity, it was 395 reshares. So that was a popular one, yeah?
Yeah.
They're not all like that, I wish. but then we can carry on going down through and clicking on each of these and just see, you know, what's the more general type of topic. And I can see who's plus one or not. You know, you're with me from here.
Yeah.
Therefore, if I want to, then I can start then... adding those people to different circles, those people that reshare, those people that comment, those people that plus one. And then I can even be a little bit more granular. I can say those people that reshare this specific type of content, those people that reshare this specific, those people reshare that. Yeah. Same for comments and plus ones. And then I ask myself, okay, these people are always commenting on my post, but they're not necessarily resharing it. So what do I need to do in order to tick that extra box in their mind that will then encourage them to, or motivate them,
mm-hmm.
to reshare a post? And that goes with ongoing relationship building, you know, getting a better understanding of my network and what drives them more, you know, mm-hmm. do stuff, what ticks their boxes. And as I start to get to know people more, I can tailor content specifically that I post. You know, when I write something, I tend to have a handful of people in mind that I'm writing it for based on questions that I get asked. So I'm not sure if you had the same adverts in the States, but when Windows 7 was launched, there was a series of adverts over here in the UK where they're saying Windows 7 was my idea. Yeah.
Right.
And irrespective of if I feel good about Windows or bad about Windows, that for me was something great for me. Because if you keep in mind that you're writing a post almost directly to those people, and then you can ping them and let them know that you've answered that question, the chances are they're going to reshare it or at least engage on that piece of content more, because you're specifically answering those questions for them.
Love it.
Yeah. That's cool.
Very good.
So I'm going to end the broadcast right now. And for everyone that's been watching and taking part, thank you very much. And feel free to leave any comments and feedback in the comment section below. And I'll see you again soon.